out to Flanders, my Malio. Well, you go to Flanders, my bonny Malio. There we'll have ale and brandy, sack and sugar candy. Oh, will you go to Flanders, my Malio?
I have seen wipers. In fact, I'm lying there now. We hold this place for moral effect only. Our troops would be far better off behind the canal. For an ideal. In holding it, men have died for a dream.
Very moving, John, and of course that really sets the scene for your book. Welcome to Good Living. How are you?
Thank you. Fine today, thank you.
Now, this book, From the Uttermost Ends of the Earth, the New Zealand Division on the Western Front, is an amazing historical account. Tell us the story behind how you came to write this book.
Well, to start it, well, it evolved rather than was written, if I can put it like that. I had three uncles who served on the Western Front in those days, and in 1997 I went there for the first time to retrace their steps, and I wrote a small family memoir for children and grandchildren later on to let them know where they'd served. Happily, they all survived, and they were indeed uncles quite close to me. Mm. And then in 2005 I expanded it somewhat, but it was still just family memoir, no intention of publishing it. And I gave a copy to the Christchurch Library just to thank them for help I'd had. And they rang me up one day and said, do you mind if we digitise it? Well, I've got to admit, Megan, in 2005 I didn't know what that meant. So I just passed that off by saying, I don't mind how you make use of it. And then I started getting emails from people asking for information and advice. Mm. So that was the origin of it in the first stage, shall we say.
And so then, and of course, it ends up being this amazing big book, you know, 5 years later.
Yes, well, there's a lot of book. and the reason for that is that people seek detail. Mm. And the sort of inquiries I had and still get, and will get many more now this is published, the sort of thing, my great uncle died on such and such a day, we know where he's buried, can you tell me where he was wounded? He was in the 4th Rifles, he was wounded on the 28th of March 1918, where was he? And people want rather more than just, oh, on the Somme or, you know, in some generality. They really want to know to within 100 square metres perhaps where it was. And one is able to do that with the detail in the book.
So it's very important for a lot of people, and I know also important for you, John, to kind of bring the Western Front out of the shadows of our other historic battles such as Gallipoli and things.
Yes. Well, my generation was brought up on Gallipoli. Mm. And could be excused for thinking that the war started and finished there. Mm. Pardon me. And Gallipoli, important though it was in the New Zealand national consciousness, was militarily not nearly as important as the division on the Western Front subsequently. For many, many reasons, the level of sacrifice on the Western Front, it was a terrible war there. There were more New Zealanders killed serving in that division in 2.5 years than in all three armed services put together in the 6 years of World War II. That's the sort of statistic I wasn't aware of, and I believe many others wouldn't have been. But more significant, perhaps, that was where the modern New Zealand Army was born, where it first fought as a division in the modern concept of it, and where it contributed to the defeat of the main enemy in the main theatre of war. And that's the only occasion when New Zealanders have served in that capacity.
The scale of the sacrifice is huge, isn't it? I know, John, that the book is being it's being put out next week, which is great.
It's so there's being launched next week.
Wonderful, yes. Launch next week. Mm-hmm. And it is available in bookstores now. So as John mentioned, there's so much information in here. There's a fantastic historical account, and it's available in all good bookstores for $80 now.
So, hopefully, yes. Yeah. They're not good bookstores unless they do.
Exactly. John, it's been lovely to meet you. Thank you so much for coming in. This work is incredible, so congratulations.
Thank you.